It's one of the most common household products in your home, probably. But children have been dying around them for decades.
Nothing seems to slow it down, not parent supervision or government intervention. And tonight we want to warn you, some of the video you're about to see is very disturbing. The 5i team's Chris Hayes shows you this blind danger that's everywhere and not getting much safer.
You go to great lengths to protect your children, keeping them out of harm's way in your home.
911 emergency.
But something you might not think of could kill your child.
She was in bed, you know, checked her, went back in there because we heard her at the door, my youngest daughter at the door, and I saw my daughter hanging there by her neck.
3-year-old Brooke Lynn Bauerlein was supposed to be sleeping, but police think she may have climbed to peek out a window so she could see people gathering for the lunar eclipse.
She was my first child. She meant the world to me. She was my heart and my soul.
This is a home video about to catch a kid nearly strangling.
Hi, Kelsey.
This family is spending time together in one room.
Sharon.
Right behind Mom, who's using the camera. Her 3-year-old son is choking. You can't hear it.
Can you feed the other baby some cereal?
You wouldn't think anything is wrong, but you're about to see it. The mother drops the camera and calls 911. Dad performs CPR, and 50 seconds later, relief. This kid survived. The Consumer Product Safety Commission reports more than 300 kids died in mini blinds in the 1990s. At least 9 kids strangled this year alone. Few people seem to be getting the message. The 5i team checked random apartments in the same complex Brooke Bauerlein died just this May. In several units, we found old, now recalled blinds, old looped pull cords, this one right next to a toddler in her room. We immediately hooked the cord out of reach and notified apartment management. No one has returned our calls.
Kids can strangle themselves in many ways with these blinds. They'll often pull out an inner cord, which forms a loop. Newer blinds should have 2 tassels instead of a loop, but they can still easily tangle to form a loop.
That's how the parents of this child, caught on videotape, said their 3-year-old got caught up and nearly strangled.
So it was a safe, what the industry would consider safe, window blind that her child was being injured on.
Linda Kaiser began an organization called Parents for Window Blind Safety after her daughter strangled in an inner cord.
Both of the recalls have failed to reduce the number of deaths. The industry knows. They know.
Let's take the most recent recall. According to the CPSC, window blinds sold since November 2000 have attachments on the pull cords so that the inner cords can't form a loop if pulled by a young child. The 5i team found that's not true. We found recalled window blinds at a local Walmart. Some had the updated cord stop attachments, which prevent a child from pulling out a loop. Others did not. Linda Kaiser says recalled blinds are everywhere.
I bought these blinds yesterday, and none of these blinds have inner cord stoppers on them, which means for 3 years, old defective window treatments have been sold, and consumers have no idea that these window treatments are unsafe.
Mike Bauerlein worries about renters who don't even have the chance to shop for a safer product because their apartments have chosen for them.
This was a skull and crossbones that was already in an apartment that I leased, and there was nothing I could do about it.
The 5i team notified the Consumer Product Safety Commission about our purchase. It is investigating. A Walmart spokesperson thanked us for bringing it to their attention and said it is also investigating. There are still other ways in which kids can strangle in any corded window treatment. Learn more about what you can do to protect yourself. Go to our website at news5.tv. And in the 5i team section, you'll see this report and a link to Parents for Window Blind Safety. You'll find more ways to protect yourself and how to get involved. For the 5i team, I'm Chris Hayes, News 5.